Well, I think we have heard a round of first speech by those speakers. So I would like to get into the session of commenting with the commentators. Well, the model of a culture from now is a topic that we'll discuss from now. So first of all, I'd like to ask Mr. Nakatsu, professor. He asked me to give him some time. Well, from Professor Koyamada, I have heard about bunka, the culture and umami. In the email from Professor Koyamada, he mentioned the culture is umami. Umami is a kind of Japanese seaweed-based taste. And the culture is to confine, encapsulate the umami taste. So there is a source of new, unique culture in Edo period when umami, the taste, Japanese taste, is encapsulated into food. And Professor Koyamada used the computer graphics to visualize what is invisible. He's researching in technology. So Professor Koyamada, would you please give us a comment from your specialty? Well, I think you have summarized what I want to tell. So visualization is what I'm doing, and making a model of the things. That is my work and the positioning. Myself, I am in front of executive chef of Kicho. I am afraid to tell this, but the cooking is my hobby. So many ways of cooking is what I am researching on. And in that, there is a technique to confine umami, or the taste. And so is it related to Japanese culture or not? And so Professor Tosa asked me that the accumulating those pieces of information to explain about the Japanese culture. So I just would like to explain my part. In one word, there is a word of sakoku, or closure of a country, or cutting diplomatic tie with foreign countries. Well, people are mentioning about the negative aspect of sakoku, or a closure of a country. Well, we are the island country. We are separated. We're likely to be falling to the state of closing the nation. I can understand in my own feeling as well. However, from the Edo period, still, there is a path or the chance to get across to foreign culture and absorb some of the element there. And so in the sakoku or diplomatic closure period, we are able to, in a way, close in the taste within ourselves. Well, when you bake hamburger, you bake one side strongly, both sides, and then after that you bake with a weak, small fire to gradually bake inside. So first you bake strongly for the surface. That is to confine or close in the taste. And hearing the presentation so far, I have felt that in the closed country, sometimes culture is in a way closed in. Well, in a kind of polytheism, or the Tashinkyo, or 8 million god, sometimes it's a risky path, but by having that 8 million gods, we are able to, in a way, kind of confine or concentrate the essence of our culture within Japan. In Wikipedia, umami is already expressed in alphabetic character as is umami. So that's the Japanese taste anyway. Well, in cooking, umami is now being discussed as is, and I think it's the term for executive chef Mr. Tokuoka to speak. Well, there are many techniques to come up with umami or create umami, but what is the unique feature of umami? As in the first presentation of Mr. Tokuoka, you mentioned that Japanese culture is very different from other culture in quality. And I think umami has something to share with Japanese culture. Yes, umami is now being expressed as a kind of alphabetic character, Roman character, and it's already used. In Kikunari Ikeda of Tokyo University found the glutamate many years ago. That's the origin of umami discovery. And there were four tastes which is recognized in the world. And China, they have additional kinds of but this is not the taste, but the kind of a stimulation, I think. So basically, the sweet, salty feeling, and the sourness and the bitterness are basically coming from, in French cuisine education, those four tastes are kind of acknowledged. But in addition, we have umami in Japan. Well, 100 years ago, the glutamate was found, but it was not well or generally received as a new taste. It's only past several years it was recognized. In 1982, Ajinomoto Company took a lead to create the Society of Umami Worldwide in Hawaii, and gradually people began to notice that umami is a great taste, especially Japanese food is becoming popular as a healthy food, and people in the world are starting to recognize Japanese food. At the same time, umami is recognized as well. The receptor to feel the glutamate in our tongue was found, actually. And also in our stomach, the receptor to sense the glutamate exists. That was found recently. So this is a necessary element for our lives, for us to live. And so it is proven to be essential ingredient. And from the, seeing the glutamate of a seaweed and the bonito are combined, and then after in our brain, kinds of stimulation to sense the pleasure is released. So, in our side, and glutamate is having the synergistic effect to each other. It was recognized as a very Japanese-specific element. However, it's found that glutamate is found in cheese and tomato as well, or the red meat of fish is having a sign as well. Kind of inosinic acid. It's not sweet, but it's as felt as a tasteful, good taste. So that is umami in Japanese translation. And so umami is becoming received as is. However, there is no comparative equivalent word to express umami as a sense. However, it existed actually in each culture, Africa, Russia, anywhere. The inosinic acid and glutamate are the components necessary for our biology, the life. These are already taken, have been taken in their own food, in their culture, and it existed for a long time. So as the same human being, are the tastefulness could be the same, could be similar in direction in any culture, I feel. But how that can be shared, how that information can help you, I changed the PowerPoint a bit. In making the model of the culture, the first sentence is dividing that in model and data. And then first question is that do they have equivalent in overseas? I think that umami is one of the equivalent of having the comparative example in overseas. Yeah, well, umami actually is a very complex sense. So the receptor on our tongue, there are several types in one receptor, and there are several points to catch or capture the sweet, and more than 50 places to capture bitterness. So the sweet, bitter, is well expressed than umami to express tastefulness or else a smell, scent, flavor. More than 380 types of the smell, the sense of a smell exist. So maybe this should be expressed in smell or kind of a temperature, sense of hot, cold, or else a kind of a tactile sense in mouth, you know, oral cavity. So some are slippery, some are rough. So to express the tastefulness, more than expressing the sense, the kind of feeling of the, for example, how can you we express the tastefulness of a raw fish? Not just that information, knowledge related to express the tastefulness, and also visual information, looking at the food and you feel it like tasty, looks tasty. And the food which you see for the first time never seems to be tasty at the first glance. So the when we consider Japanese cuisine for the future, I think we are coming to the borderless age. The restaurant in Singapore this time, or Monaco, or somewhere else, Japanese restaurant in those countries should be different from what we have in Kyoto, because raw material environments are all different there. So in such a different climate, in front, how we are able to give a satisfaction to the guests in front of us. Maybe there are Japanese or Africans or other race in the restaurant overseas, but how to give satisfaction to them? We need to exercise any power or capability that we have. Well, you have given a lot of the information about umami using FX. It's a kind of function, the equation. So when we go overseas, there is a Japanese restaurant, but the taste is slightly different. And that is customized to the taste of local people, and that is a variable part of the equation. What do you think, Professor Nakatsu? You are living in Singapore, I think. So earlier, in explaining cultural computing, to deal with the culture by computer, at that time we had the I explained simply the algorithm and data. The data could be the area, race. Algorithm could be common or should be have some commonality. In a way, very rough simplification I gave you earlier. However, hearing your presentation, it may be too much to say that there is a typology already exists of, to speak about the Kyoto culture, the food and restoration of culture, or the patterns and the dyeing, and also the unity of Shintoism and Buddhism, weaving. Well, those typology is already existed, and the cultural computing can be complete with that much variety of Kyoto culture. Maybe too much, but that is the first thing I observed. But when I hear individual speech, that is about the content of the data anyway, then this is very local dependent, or a kind of dependent on the craftsman, each craftsman or professional. And that data dependency part is so heavy, so great. That is very difficult part. But, well, computing is not able to enter into that area. That is up to the artist, that is up to the craftsman anyway. So what computer can do is to support these work of a craftsman in each area, just supporting their work. But at the same time, I would like to see the same similar things in overseas. So there is a room for computer to get in. However, you say that the God resides in the detail, but that part is up to the artist, and the computer is not able to handle. So the unity of Shintoism and the Buddhism, well, that is very unique to Japan. I talk about Greek polytheism, and that is very similar to Japanese situation. Buddhist also is a very unique as a religion. So in Greek, Roman, there are a lot of the god and the goddess, and they were destroyed by the Christianity. Even though the Christianity come to Japan, the Shintoism and Buddhism still survive and unite in each other. That is very unique situation. I don't know whether this is unique to Japan, but I think it's worth computing anyway. So you are summarizing it very well on the slide, hearing what you said. Well, we are speaking about globalism, but in each field, the very precious thing, if there is any precious thing that can be surviving in a global age, or the strengths of your own field, we'd like to hear from each of the speaker. Let's hear from Mr. Tokuoka.
In the Japanese cuisine, visuality, appearance, and how to construct the structure of the food is quite different from other countries. The unification seems to be very important in Western culture. The chief and ties or belt and bag and shoes, and also the cutlery, so unified design, uniformity is very important in Europe, West, but it varies in Japan. Lacquer wares, porcelain, and glass and metal, and those all varieties of the things that got together and create the value. And the patterns and the colors of kimono, those seems to be much different and much variation. But within that variation, there is unity. Or you disguise, or you imitate, and you copy things, and that make the value, and that's the Japanese culture. And visually expressed that when it comes to cuisine, this is how to decorate the cuisine. French, Italian, the worldwide the cuisine, the shoyu is much used. as a seasoning. So it becomes to be very popular thanks to kikkoman. And olive oils also used. Paris, New York, Tokyo, the kitchens just the same. I think there are artists to draw a picture, not the symmetry, but the asymmetry is important. So decoration of cuisine, food is very important in the Japanese cuisine. And that's a strength, maybe. So the beauty, formalities and form, beauty of the forms. Usami-san. So repairing and restoration is my work, and how to decorate alcoves. Tatami culture is there. And also there's a Kyoto culture. The Kyohyogu is one of the expressions, and Edo and Kaga, they have their different styles. But in the past, there are the differences. So the nobility's culture and the warriors' the culture, the bushi and samurai culture, and the space is different, environment is different, and we use the cloth and materials, but the sense is quite different. The Kyoto, we prefer subdued, subtle expression.
東京、まあ、江戸兵庫ではやっぱりダイナミックな武家社会、まあ、よく言われるの。
In Edo, you enter, there are dragons and tigers and very vivid design. But in Kyoto, we have much subdued, subtle expression. 山口さん。I'm not sure this will be inherited, but Karakami, the paper, the surface is very rough. So the brand new thing seems already very old. So you have the good taste on the surface of the moss. So if that kind of the value continues, then the beauty of the paper will be used. So those are the wood blocks. Those are breakable, fragile, and if those are broken, we can remake those.
はい、まあ、つづれ織り。
つづれ織り is for kimono. And that's the folk clothes, the kimono. But if we leave it as it is, there will be the mistakes. The cultural computing, koto, ono, kiku are there on the kimono pattern, and that's the very radical design. But that is a pan, listen to the fact it's good. So Mon and Gara and Iro, and those will be discussed later. But you do not go into that the deep area, just the superficial, the surface will be they put much emphasis on, and that is a unfortunate situation. About umami and the Kyoto culture, and what will be remained. I study that, and I also practice it.
なんですね。で、私は物学、技学という観点。
And the mono study and waza study I do. So the spirituality and the physicality, I always talk about the story. And the waza, the technique, it contains many, many different aspects. And the unity of the Shintoism and the Buddhism, the, in the Kyoto culture, what will be remained? And what the should be remained? That is like Aoi Matsuri, Gion Matsuri, and Kasuga Taisha Festival, Onmatsuri Festival, in Shinshu, Onbashira Festival. And those indeed are important festivals people try to protect. And if those will be disappeared, and Japanese culture will be disappeared, in terms of design in Gion Festival, you also have the ritual aspect, and also each float had a different design, very radical design, and there is a community to protect, and there is organization, collaborations, and also music, the Hayashi music. So everything will be gathered together and come up with the festival, Aoi Gion Festivals. So especially it's related with the Kicho, Shinsen, the rice and food given, donated to the god. And Onmatsuri Shinsen and Kasuga Taisha Shinsen, those sacred food are completely different. And each those secret, sacred, the rice, very, very beautiful and erotic in my sense. So in Shinsen, there is much spirituality and concentration and technologies incorporated. So I'm one of the person in the research, but I every time I discover that, I'm very much surprised. So the god wants to eat the something tasty, but it's a virtual thing. We don't know which one is the taste of the god, but that's a virtual inspiration and thinking, and you decorate that sacred food and try to donate it to the god. That's the spirit of the festival too, and those are all connected. So the characteristics of the Kyoto culture and what to be remained, preserved, and as a cultural model, we can consider those. And information people, computer people should take care of those. So you do compute something. Information engineering and IT researchers, they try to measure those. They measure everything and then see the difference and do computing, calculation. But something else is there. There is some meanings, and try to describe that meanings as a model. So we have to seek for those models. And Dr. Professor Kurohashi, do you have any comment? Hearing that, those engineering analysis, and apart from those the analysis by engineers, is there any other models or any other methodologies?
Well, Professor Kurohashi, well, I think since I'm working on the language processing, so this computing in intelligence engineering, I think it was in the 1980s, so it's a little different from the measuring, but there was an expert system at that time, and it was a specialist, it was like a medical diagnosis or nuclear energy. So how to identify, how to clarify is what we did, and it was a kind of a success. And so people who had a know-how written out what is to be expected, and so we came up with the automatic diagnosis system. And it was quite interesting listening to the discussion so far, the difference with overseas and where we want to leave have a legacy. We need to identify, clarify the things, and so expert system method, I think, or approach could be utilized. And when we want some legacy, there would be some senses some sensual thing, but that's something else. And first of all, to kind of identify or visualize what the craftsmen have is quite important. And although we're in the field of informatics, we know that the computers are lack the flexibility and they're not so smart. But in modeling all of the problems, it's quite good, because if the computers are so flexible, then it's like if the computers learned things without could understand everything with just a small input, then it's difficult to for the computers to identify the issues and problems. So it's good in that way. So your for the skills that the craftsmen have, that the, can we really externalize or visualize that? Well, if that is not if it's not possible right now, what needs to be done is, I think, what it will be quite interesting. And Professor Koyamata, like Mr. Usami, is restoring the artwork. And so, like, if we want to simulate, is it possible to visualize something if we want to simulate the restoration work? I thought that that could be possible. Well, listening to the discussion, terahertz is, well, the there's some pre-processing done for the restoration work, and I had a discussion with these people, and the people in the past have been doing the restoration, and to show this process, how to visualize this process, is what has been now worked on at the Anala Cultural Property Research Institute is starting this effort, how to visualize these restoration work, and the model is being developed. And so we can appreciate what the restorers of the past have been doing. So if we could have that system developed, then the restoration work, I think, would be increasingly successful, is what I felt. Well, we're running out of time. So in establishing a model of the culture, well, we tried to come up with a model. And so how to interact and experience the culture and to understand it and to transmit the culture. I think this is an important mission of the cultural computing. And what we want to do is, along with the maestros and the Shinto priests, how can we use the computers to make this happen? And also some people were talking about cross-culture. So how we can customize or identify the differences and similarities with the foreign culture, how we can use the computer. So this is a discussion often done in the field of engineering, how to transmit the like the tacit knowledge, the skills, the tacit knowledge is what we'd like to discuss now. Professor Nakatsu. Hi. I've said all I wanted to say, so, well, we have the audience in the floor, so I think that we need, it's good to receive some questions from the floor, but, well, I think Japanese food is enjoyed by five senses, so visual information is important, is what was said, but actually it's the tongues, or the, we smell, or the taste, or the touch. So on the internet, using the internet, If such data can be sent through the internet, and if there's a system that's ever, is there a system where we could send such sensual information like the smell, the touch, the visual information, like the smell? There are many scientists who say, well, the receptor, some say receptors sense the material. Well, I think it's up to the two individual whether the such a system can be developed. What I think is risky is that in the internet age, the physical senses are weakening in humans. Like for taste, I think we still maintain the senses, but the smell, we tend to avoid strong smell. So now the society is becoming smellless. In Singapore, in the taxi, we have a lot of smell. In Kyoto is odorless, I feel, compared to Singapore. So in the internet, there's no smell. So in the past, there were a lot of ladies who wear perfumes. We could smell the perfume, but recently, we don't have sense any smell. So how does it affect the taste? I feel that the current situation is kind of risky. So in the field of taste, the world trend is so now the temperature-wise, the temperature is becoming medium level. It's not so hot, so cold. So Japanese people want to eat hot food hot and cold food cold. And one of the features of Japanese food is that we eat raw food, and we want to be spreading this tradition. And so there's a lot of know-how in the Japanese culinary culture, or the technique, not only the technique and the skills, but what is supporting the Japanese food or the cuisine is the accumulation of the primary industry, effort of the primary industry. So in the global market, if we can sell the software so that the people on the primary industry can flourish or enjoy the benefit, I think that would be helpful if the internet could be used in that way, is what I felt.